Hi and welcome to Lunchtime Prayer Power. I'm Deidre Banks. Today we're praying for the Entertainment Mountain, and I'm super excited about this. I'm excited to come with prayer and pray with you each and every day. But there's some particular mountains that there's a passion there for these particular mountains. And one of those is entertainment. And I'm called to the Entertainment Mountain. Now I won't go into all that I'm doing there, but there's some projects that I'm working on that God has showed me ways to reach the lost in this area as well as in media as well. So some areas that I'm particularly passionate about, as well as education. Our foundation, the Banks Foundation, Inc., started in 2017, the National Day of Love, and it's a celebration of love through giving. Our mission through the Banks Foundation, Inc. is to empower families to reach their full potential through love and education. And so we have school supplies, scholarships, educational sponsorships, and we do also community outreach. Now, the National Day of Love is on the third Saturday in March, and we have many projects that we work on with our communities. You could take a look at that on nationaldayoflove.org. But I'm mentioning this to you because I'm very passionate about what God is doing, and He's doing things on all the mountains, so we don't take any of them lightly. But this is one that I'm close to personally. And again, there are several things that I'm working on that will be rolling out in the near future, God willing, in the near future. But today we're going to pray for the Entertainment Mountain. Now, the Entertainment Mountain includes music, filmmaking, television, social media, and the performing arts. Amen. And the performing arts. And so in this area, I also include sports. Now, it's not part of the general definition that you may be familiar with, but sports is also an area of entertainment. And we are seeing opportunities. I say we, but meaning the Holy Spirit is showing me opportunities in that. And there's people who are speaking out in sports about their faith. They're speaking out. There's football players who proclaiming that God is helping them. And we've seen this before with several people even in who are playing years before. Tim Tebow was very active about his faith. Amen. Even writing scriptures. And I know there's other basketball players writing scriptures on their shoes. And we see opportunity here for the gospel to be proclaimed and also people to speak about their faith. Amen. So we want to pray for sports as well. That is a very tough environment, as is entertainment as well. There's a lot of pressure. There's a lot of young people that are in that and a lot of young people watching them. So it's a great opportunity for God to raise up individuals that are after His own heart to be a light unto the lost, of people that can identify with them. Amen. So what is God doing on the Entertainment Mountain? Well, we want to pray for God to raise up Christians to rise up in arts and entertainment. Again, we're seeing some believers rise up in these areas who are proclaiming their faith, and it is a light unto the lost. So we've seen this. We've seen people come out, and we want to pray for more people to express their faith and more people to become saved in these areas. God is giving people visions of what to do on the Entertainment Mountain. God's giving people vision. God pours out vision. And as we're open, as the church is open, believers open to what God wants to do, He's going to use us. God has an amazing way of reaching us. Just as He met Apostle Paul, who used to be Saul on the road to Damascus, He can reach unbelievers and open their eyes to see. Amen. So the vision that God is pouring out, Habakkuk 2:2 tells us we should write the vision and make it plain. Then the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain on tablets, that he may run who reads it. Amen. That he may run who reads it. So those that are receiving visions in the Entertainment Mountain, that God is giving them vision. He's pouring out a vision. He's even calling people from other areas. God can do anything. Now, we want to pray for God to have His way, that He's raising up people in arts and entertainment to be a light unto the lost. Amen. We're also praying for provision for them, that they'll have provision to do the work that God is calling them to do. God gives bread, amen, to the eater, and He gives seed to the sower. 2 Corinthians 9:8-11. I'm going to read this in the Message Bible. God can pour on the blessings in astonishing ways so that you're ready for anything and everything, more than just ready to do what needs to be done. As one psalmist puts it, he throws caution to the winds, giving to the needy in reckless abandon. His right living, right giving ways never run out, never wear out. This most generous God who gives seed to the farmer that becomes bread for your meals is more than extravagant with you. He gives you something you can then give away, which grows into full-formed lives, robust in God, wealthy in every way, so that you can be generous in every way, producing with us great praise to God. Amen. God is giving us power to generate wealth, and we use that wealth to advance the kingdom of God. Amen. There's overflow. God gives us abundance. We are sowing into the kingdom. We're advancing the kingdom of God. God is blessing us with the seed to be able to do these things. And we're going to pray for that. Amen. We're going to pray for that. God gives us some to enjoy ourselves. We don't give everything away. There's some part that we enjoy for ourselves, but we give unto the Lord. As a widow in the Bible gave her last mite, she gave more than the others who were giving much more because she gave her last. Amen. And so we want to give to the Lord, knowing that he's going to replenish. He's going to give us more. We're going to overflow. We're going to have more than enough as we sow into the kingdom of God. Amen. It's a blessing to be able to give to others. Let your light so shine, Matthew 5:16 tells us, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you, Lord. You are an amazing God, a God of abundance, a God of vision. You see all things. You know all things. You have a plan for us that's good and not of evil, for a future and a hope. You have a plan for this generation. You have a plan for our country. You have a plan. You have a plan. You have a plan. So we ask you now, Father God, pour out your vision. Pour out your plans upon this earth. Pour out so we may receive from you and flow in you and produce what you want us to produce, Father God. We want to produce Holy Ghost, Holy Spirit inspired content for the masses. We want to produce, we want to make films and music and television, social media and performing arts, sports that are unto you, Father God. That we are doing things that glorify you. That we're celebrating in ways that honor you. That we are laying it all down to do what you've called us to do. Help us to write down the vision and make it plain so that we can run with it. Help us to remember what you have called. Some you've told years ago and we didn't write it down, or we wrote it down and we don't remember where it was and we never looked at it. Help us to take out the books and the journals and the archives in our computer. Help us to go back to the plans that you had for us. Help us to go back what you called us to do in this hour. Help us, Father God, to go back, to go back, to go back, so we can go forward, not holding on to the past in regret, but looking back to what you told us so that we can run freely. Remind us, Father God, with your Holy Spirit, what you told us. Some never wrote it down, Father God, but you remember all things. You remember. So breathe on us again, Father God. Breathe on us fresh, overflowing. Breathe on us again and lead us in the ways of everlasting. Lead us in the ways of understanding, Father God. Lead us beside still waters and help us, Lord, to draw from you, from the river of living water that never runs out. Help us, Father God, to remember what you have told us to do. Help us to remember your word so that we can plant securely, that when we create projects, that they're an honor to you, that they're honoring the word of God, that they're not against scripture, but that we flow in the ways of you, that we flow. Help us, Father God, to walk in miracles, signs, and wonders in these areas that we're called to walk into in entertainment, that we may go forth miraculously doing things, finishing things earlier than expected, that people are getting healed by the ministry going forth in the films, in the music, in the television, Father God, that they would see the work that's coming forth that's Holy Spirit inspired and breathed, and some that will get saved from seeing these things, some getting healed from looking upon the and hearing the testimonies, Father God, some receiving inner healing by reading and watching these things on television, Lord. We pray right now, Father God, that there would be mass awakenings, mass revivals, mass healings come forth from the entertainment that's produced. Let it be fruitful, Father God, fruit that remains. We desire, Father God, to please you in all our ways. And so we lay down every snare, we lay down every hindrance, every fear, every anxiety about stepping forth in what you called us to do. And we ask you, Father God, breathe on us again. Overflow. Fill us up, Lord, to overflowing. Fill us up, Father God, that we may pour out, that our lives will be a drink offering. Poured out for you, Father God. We pray for abundance. For the projects, Father God, abundance and the provision that we can walk up what you called for us to do. You are a giving God. You give to the needy. You give to the righteous, Father God. You give, you give, you give. Help us to give. Help us to overflow, to be generous, not stingy, not lazy, but help us to stay true to what you called us to do and do everything in excellence. Help us, give us favor in the financial realm so we may step forth in the projects you've called us to do. That we may live in abundance, Lord, and overflow and have things to give to others. That we will not hoard for ourselves, but that we will pour out and give out to others. Forgive us, Father God, for hoarding things back for ourselves that you meant for us to give. And yes, you want us to have nice things. You want us to enjoy. There's a portion you've called us to give out to the kingdom and tithes and offerings, and other to give out to fellow believers, and some to give out to unbelievers. Help us, Father God, and forgive us, Lord, for being stingy with our resources. Forgive us, Father God, for not giving when you told us to give. Forgive us, Lord, for being afraid to give. Help us to trust you more. Give us more of you. Fill us up, Father God. Fill us up and help us, Father God, to trust you more. Give us more confidence in you because you are righteous, God. You're holy. You cannot lie. You're not the son of man that you should lie, Father God. So help us, Lord. Help us, Father God, in this hour to remember your promises. Remember your goodness. Overflow in our lives. Lord, and help us to give. Give like you give. Help us to source other projects. Help us to source the work of the church. Help us to be the hands and feet of Jesus in this hour. And help us not to eat our seed. Forgive us, Lord, for eating our seed when we were supposed to sow. And instead, we cast it away. We buried it. We didn't do what we were supposed to do. Help us, Lord, and forgive us, Father God. We thank you, Lord, for the projects that are coming forth. We thank you that we are running freely. We thank you that the wind is at our backs, that we're moving in line with you, that we're overflowing. We thank you, Father God. You're a good God, and we thank you for who you are. We praise you. We lift your name on high. You're awesome and you're mighty, and we thank you, Lord, for the great works that are coming through the church in this hour to save souls, amen, to awaken us. Thank you, Father God, for your goodness. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God is doing a mighty work in the entertainment mountain, amen. Let's continue to pray for God to move and to raise up souls so that the lost may be saved. Be blessed. Have an awesome day.